What's good, everybody? Just wanted to do a quick video and unboxing on this new phone, the Unihertz Titan, which showed up last week from a Kickstarter campaign. If you don't already know about this phone, then what you'll probably notice is that it bears a striking resemblance to the BlackBerry Passport. And I got to say that on first initial impressions, this thing delivers. So I've been using this for a few hours now, just going through some of the basic apps and functions, and the overall impression is that this is the BlackBerry Passport, born again, in beast mode. I mean, just look at the size of this thing. It's even bigger than the BlackBerry Passport because it has a few extra rows and a fingerprint reader. It's also much thicker than the BlackBerry Passport, which is something I personally didn't mind at all. For me, once you go with a phone this big, a few extra inches of thickness isn't really going to make much of a difference, but to each his own. So yeah, if big and thick phones aren't your thing, then you might want to look somewhere else, but after using the BlackBerry Passport for a few years, the size and width of this phone really didn't bother me. The original Passport was already kind of cumbersome to handle in one hand, and this really isn't a difference, but you can still manage as the heft really centers it down onto your fingers. Just using this phone for a few hours, it kind of feels like Unihertz started with the BlackBerry Passport, and they added every conceivable feature and function that you can think of to add on to a phone. Fingerprint reader? Check. Headphone jack? Check. USB-C port? Check. Wireless charging? Check. Water resistance? Check. Full-size backlit QWERTY keyboard with a fingerprint reader and four other tactile buttons? Check. So yeah, the reason why you're probably looking at this video and interested in this phone and were interested in the original BlackBerry Passport is the keyboard. And here it is on the Unihertz Titan. Three rows of letters along with a five button row that has your caps button, your home button, your back button, and your alternate key button. Just using this for a few hours now, I can tell you that the keyboard definitely works well, and it's a nice change of pace from all the virtual keyboards that are released these days. There's been a lot of chatter online about key presses not registering and other issues with the keyboard, but overall I found this to be a very functional, tactile QWERTY keyboard. It's not quite up there yet with the slickness and execution on a normal BlackBerry or even the original BlackBerry Passport, but I'm gonna give this phone a chance as I want to let my fingers and my brain train my muscles to get used to some of the features and some of the shortcuts on this thing. One thing that did stand out for me though was I forgot how nice it was to have a physical back button. The capacitive back buttons on my old Samsungs were quite a nice convenience, but it's been a good minute since I've had a physical back button, and I forgot how nice it is just to press that button down and be able to go back on a web page. Stay tuned for the full keyboard review, and I'll try to go more in depth about how typing and browser navigation and other things work with this physical keyboard. Build quality wise, it's kind of more of the same, as this kind of feels like how the BlackBerry Passport was built, except on steroids. You have a metal chassis outfitted with a rubber body. If the BlackBerry Passport is the slick business suit version of this combination, then the Unihertz Titan is definitely body armor. In terms of the performance and the internals, this is definitely a welcome refresh of what we found on the BlackBerry Passport. Most obviously is that you have Android running on this thing. Those of us that have struggled for years with the BlackBerry Passport and BlackBerry 10 will know how much of a welcome change this is. Unihertz Titan also comes with some pretty beefy internals. It's running the MediaTek Helio P60 octa-core, and has 6 GB of RAM with 128 GB of internal storage. Overall, I found things to be pretty snappy, and you'll see some benchmarking tests on my full review. So these are my first impressions of the Unihertz Titan. Overall, having it in my hand and playing with some apps for a few hours, this thing is quite a unique phone. It has the form factor of the BlackBerry Passport, but it's equipped with modern offerings like Android and much stronger internals. I'll have to see how the keyboard performs compared to the BlackBerry Passport, as there's been a lot of rumblings on the software implementation of Unihertz's QWERTY keyboard. Stay tuned for the full review for a breakdown of the keyboard and other features of this beast of a phone. If you have one yourself, leave a message below to let me know what you think and how the keyboard's working out for you. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.